Well, been waiting for this for 15 years. I mean, what, Shogun Total War came out in 2000? And I started playing Warhammer back in 2001, like the tabletop. So I've always felt that Total War is the perfect venue for Warhammer to finally come to the PC, but the wait has been long, but it's finally here. I'm pretty excited, I gotta be honest. I've been deliberately not watching streams and not spoiling too much. I've looked at a bit of things, but not that many. So, I'm gonna blunder my way through this, and we'll see what happens. I fucked with options a bit, so we're looking at... Turn off projectile trails, those annoy me. The marker scales, we'll see how that goes. Apparently there's more options when I get into the battle. Fantastic. Of course, unit size ultra. I don't know why that's a graphics option. That's important for your game. Excuse me. But, yeah. New campaign. So, the Warhammer world, much like the 40k Warhammer, a lot more people are familiar with, is a... It's a very doomed place. Like, lore-wise, the end times is about to happen after this, and chaos wins, everyone dies. Sorry, spoilers. But, the Empire, much like the Imperium, is beset on all sides. It's, the Warhammer world is somewhat Earth-shaped, so the Empire basically takes up the position of the Holy Roman Empire in the middle of Europe, so it's Germany, effectively, but with magic. Meanwhile, the other factions, the Dwarves, which I'm sure many people are familiar with from other things, they live in the mountains, just like Yavnia. They're Dwarves, you know what Dwarves are, come on now, you've all played World of Warcraft, I'm sure. Or at least watched Lord of the Rings. Similar things. The Dwarves in Warhammer really love grudges. In fact, I've heard their gameplay in the game. Yeah, grudge missions, like it's saying right here. Orcs. Greenskins, orcs and goblins. Hyper-aggression. As in 40k, they reproduce by fighting. So fighting is literally sex to orcs. So you can't stop fighting ever. Or so I've heard. In Warhammer Fantasy, the actual armies I've collected on tabletop, I collect vampire counts, so this is very exciting for me that they're actually in the game. I played Necrarchs, which is a bloodline of vampires. Basically, vampires were created 7,000 years before present day. May not be that long, maybe 4,000, depending on how I'm remembering my Warhammer history. However, Nagash, the priest lord of Khemri, way down south in, I guess, Africa would be the closest approximation of Warhammer, created the undead. Well, he created the Elixir of Life, which gave him eternal life. But then he pissed a bunch of people off in Khemri, and they all murdered him. One of the people who murdered him, though, was Queen Neferata of the city of Lamia on the eastern coast of Khemri. And she stole the Elixir of Life and some of the books of Nagash. But she created an imperfect version of the Elixir of Life that gave Nagash eternal life. And that's how she created the vampires, who are basically immortal and very powerful, strong, fast, have natural magical abilities, but they're cursed. They have to drink blood in order to maintain themselves. Except for the Necrarch bloodline, but basically, eventually Queen Neferata was figured out, and a bunch of assholes all murdered her and her buddies. But most of the original vampires, she gave her elixir to 12 other people, who were the master vampires. A number of them were killed when Lamia was destroyed, but a number of them escaped, and each founded their own bloodline that has unique traits. Now the leader here, presumably, of Vampire Counts, is Manfred von Karstein, who is naturally of the von Karstein bloodline. Known to burn with... the ambition for mortal conquest. Now, the most famous of them is Vlad von Karstein, who invaded the Empire 500 years before the present day of this game, and nearly brought it to its knees. Manfred is his son, or his spawn, so to speak, and he's been in hiding since the end of the Vampire Wars that the Empire won, but now he's back. Like it says right here, finally being brought to bay at Hellfen and slain. But what is no longer living is never easy to kill, and Manfred has risen again. Mind you, in tabletop, I also play in 40k, I play Chaos, so I'm definitely tempted to be playing a Chaos campaign right now. My army is of Zinch, the Lord of Change, God of Magic, born from the hope of mortals. But it's not gonna happen this time. I'll play the ruinous powers later. But as much as I really want to, I have to stick with my fantasy army here. I'm not entirely sure what's good, what's not. Well, guess we'll find out. Can I select the difficulty here? I don't know. Victory objectives. Long campaign victory. 20 provinces. Blow the Empire up. Blow the Dwarves up. Blow Bretonnia up. And stop the Warriors of Chaos from invading everything. And wound Arcanon. Okay. No big deal, right? Is there a year I have to do this by, or just ever? Interesting. Eh, whatever. Let it begin. Ooh. Nice eyes, guy. Monfred, before he revealed himself at the height of his power, actually traveled about in the guise of a handsome imperial lord. But I guess he, in his interregnum, when he was away for a while being dead, went about the world increasing his magical power, and channeling that much dark magic is just not healthy, as we can kind of guess just looking at him here. So, oh, do I get a choice? Okay, Heinrich Kemmler. Powerful wizard. That's cool. Upkeep minus 25% for necromancer. That's pretty neat. Start with extra cairn rates. Wolves. That's pretty neat. Less costly raised dead. That's cool. What's man forget? Extra campaign movement range. Oh, that's nice. Upkeep minus 10% for graveguard and black knights. Actually, in my tabletop army, I use a big horde of graveguard with great weapons. And black, big box of black knights with lances, so I'm a fan of that. Faction leader, powerful melee fighter, leader, and wizard. Yes, vampires in 40k, or 40k fantasy, they're good at everything, honestly. The original vampires, as created by Neferata, were creatures of astonishing strength and resilience. But here in Total War, well, I assume they have to kind of represent, because in the game, tabletop Warhammer fantasy this is all based on, vampires are outrageously powerful and expensive, mind you, compared to necromancers. They cast just as well, pretty much, and they also kick ass in melee. So it's interesting how they'll balance that. I don't really know. Extra units. Crypt ghouls. Hell bats. Vargolf. Vargolfs are vampires who completely give in to the savage beast inside them. Anyway, I think I'm gonna go with Monfred here, just because we're playing vampire camps, we may as well have a vampire leading us, right? That makes sense. Anyway, normals for nerds. Legendary! Manual save's not allowed, this is a special saving system. So, Iron Man, no turning back. Orders cannot be issued when a battle is paused. Because, that would just make it too easy, fighting the AI, right? Yes. After Vlad was killed, a number of other von Karsteins fought it out for temporal power, like Conrad and Peter. Eventually, they all got themselves Zogged. Zog is an orc term. It means, well, it's very rude in conversation, but I'm sure you can figure it out. Anyway, so the other ones got Zogged. Monfred eventually came back, kicked ass, and became rightful lord of Sylvania, which is not a total rip of Transylvania. Yes. His newfound powers are not enough, and he thirsts forevermore as part of his designs for the Imperial Throne. Let's get this started. I'm probably gonna get my ass kicked, because I'm not used to mechanics yet.
War is eternal. As inevitable as the grave. The old world, the rotting corpse within. Some fools think it worth saving. But there are beings who wish to bring about an eternal night. I am a bearer of law to those with such power. Vampire Counts of the von Karstein bloodline. My master, Manfred, has returned from the dead once more. He marches on the von Karstein ancestral pile of Castle Dragonhof. For I have brought him ill news that a master necromancer has claimed the fortress as his own. Manfred must retake his ancient stronghold and either destroy the usurper within or bind him to his will.
Well, isn't that interesting? Marched against his former keep at Drakenhof, ever the capital of the von Karsteins. Zelig von Kruger, eh? Alright. Or Van Kruger, sorry.
Castle Drakenhof is back in your hands, my unliving sire. Yet you have many enemies.
I can't imagine why.
And dead, who balk at the threat of a von Karstein reigning from his ancestral stronghold. Much needs to be done.
You're not kidding.
The Templehof brood control the lands to the north, as far as the River Stir. Conflict with them is inevitable, but your will is indomitable. Take their lands, burn their crypts, and deploy their own dead against them. The high mountains to the south are
infested. This campaign map is so pretty.
Dwarfs. Your homelands will never be safe with such an enemy so close. Make plans to drive their stunted kind.
Wow, that's rude. Racist.
Greatness runs throughout the von Karstein bloodline, my lord. Glory shall be yours, if you are ambitious enough to seize it.
Hey, what are you trying to say? Alright, so it begins. The Templehof brood must be crushed in battle before they are able to regain their strength. Another victory against von Kruger's armies will leave his lands ripe for the taking. Defeat Templehof. Gain dark magic.
Missions
that doesn't sound like gold.
From time to time by those interested in your progress.
Uh-huh.
These can be reviewed at your request, my lord.
Uh-huh. Alright. Total dark magic. Predicted dark magic income? Obedience to the vampires. Huh. Public order up to plus 10% based on percent of vampiric corruption. I've heard that vampiric corruption works a bit like religion in the old times. Hey, technology. What we got here? Ooh. Bunch of things. What do I want? Crypt ghouls. I never used crypt ghouls in tabletop. I always went with skeletons and zombies myself. Cairn Wraiths, though. I'm big on that. Armor plus 10, Bond of Bones. Huh. Unit experience. That's funny. Extra armor for zombies. Master of the Putrid Horde. I like that. Basically, the tactics that vampire counts typically used would be a horde of unbreakable zombies and skeletons in the center, just to tie the enemy up for a bit and tire them out. And then hitting them hard in the flanks with elite units like Black Knights, Grave Guard, Cairn Wraiths, Zombie Dragons, if we really go that far. Of course, Vampire Counts themselves. Unearth Cursed White Blade. Sounds pretty cool. You know, I'm definitely leaning towards the Book of Arcane right now. Felbats, Direwolves, you know, I did have a Bat Swarm. My girlfriend painted for me, but I never was big on Direwolves. Or anything like Vargeists like that. I tended to go more with the Shambling Horde of Undead, so I'm not sure if I'll be going that route just yet. Although Chargeists are kind of neat. The Lamian Book of Blood. That's kind of cool. I like growth. Income from repression buildings. Alright. That's fantastic. Ooh, Vampiric Corruption. I like that. I like that. White Kings and Banshees? I always use Banshees in my armies. I had a White King bearing my battle standard. Vampiric Corruption. Well, that's dickish. Wow, this looks really nice. Diplomatic relations plus 10. Ooh, that might actually be really useful and legendary. Because, like, in Attila Total War, for example, when you're playing something like the Saxons on Legendary, it's really important to go attack the Roman Empire right away, because that would give you a ton of diplomatic relations with all your neighboring factions so they didn't all decide to gang up and murderize you. But, yeah. Cipher Nahakara manuscripts. Interesting. Incantations of Nagash. Well, I'm definitely going to be looking at that one. And at the same time, definitely going to be looking at well, that's kind of nice, but I'm gonna start with the Book of Arcan. Basic units, let's get those better. Yes, faction summary, dark magic summary, taxes. I'll take your dark magic, but only a percent of it, because we are fair taxation, or fair taxers I should say. Archaon the ever chosen. Pretty cool guy, I've heard. Impress me. Come impress me? Alright, what have we got here? Recruit units, raise dead. Scarytons. Zombies. They try their best, let's be honest here. Charge defense against large foes, anti-large, that's cool. Now, typically vampire counts, their basic units are garbage, and their characters are pretty good. So what's my mission here? Engage the enemy. Right, of course. Blow this idiot up. Looks like their army. Impudence.
Your last mistake.
I like that. They brought that back in Medieval 2 Total War. When you clicked on your opponents, they would mock you.
Cease.
He is a vampire lord. Huh, yeah, their stat line's pretty good, actually. What's your special rules here? Disintegrating. Leadership is above shattered, battle outcome decided. Let's see. Brutal. Invocation of Nahek. Oops. Come back. Mystical resistance. Resilience. What's that? This unit is immune to the following types of attrition. Yes. Causes fear, obviously. Courage. Hide. Undead. Does not rout. Immune to terror. Becomes unstable when leadership is low. Will suffer from attrition moving through a territory not owned by the undead. Uh-huh. Okay. Interesting. Okay. So what have I got here? I do have a Vargolf. I suppose I could just raise a bunch of dead instantly and get the fuck after him and be like, sup, you're dead. You know, in German, V's are pronounced like F's, buddy. Yeah, forget it. What do we got here in Castle Drakenhof, which apparently I already have. But I want to go take out Castle Templehof. These are very good names. I like the details in the campaign map here. This place looks pretty gross, eh? Vampiric corruption 100%. Winds of magic blowing. I like that. So I believe,
right is mine.
Monfred in the tabletop is a master of both death and vampiric magic. You got anything cool? No items. Basic armor and weapon. What about your skills? Fuck all. Okay. Passive ability replenishes HP. That's nice. Invocation of the Heck. It's always my favorite spell on the tabletop. Just because our units would never fucking die. Well, let's see how this goes. Recruit units. I can get skeletons and zombies. Yeah, fair enough. Expendable. Poor zombies. They try really hard.
I'll take Sigmar's throne.
I don't doubt that. So we have a level 2 capital building here, right? Yes. What does this get for me? Income, public order, growth. Yes. Drakenhof is the sprawling ancestral fortress of the von Karstein bloodline. Ever since the coming of Vlad, it has been the de facto political center of Sylvania. That's a pretty decent garrison. 4 crypt ghouls, 4 graveguard. Well, that's nice, actually. Oh, you can really get your garrison to ridiculous levels, can't you? Alright, what do I got here? I have a cemetery. What does that do for me? Graveyards and cemeteries are ubiquitous, a particular favorite source of fresh recruits. Quite so. I'm taxing the province, yes. Province effects. Rampant corruption. Casualty replenishment rate. That's nice. Shaiish is the elven word for the lore of death, the wind of death. Basically, at the two poles of the Warhammer world, at the north and south pole, are raging open portals to raw chaos, the warp, which is a dimension that exists basically everywhere in the mortal realm, and just beyond the veil, so to speak. And it's where the chaos gods reign. Magic that enters the world through those chaos portals, because magic is created by chaos, and foremost among them the chaos god Tzeentch, god of magic. When magic enters the mortal realm, it splits into the eight different colors of magic, which are the eight lores. That is to say, fire, beasts, metal, heavens, death, shadow. Some other things that are slipping my mind right now. There's heavens, there's light, light's that one. There's life, yes, light and life. Anyway, there's eight of them, they have different colors. And they all have an elven name, Shaiish is death, which is purple.
I grow impatient.
Anyway. Yes, I bet you do. I could build something here. What could I build? I could build military recruitment, which is a cemetery, a sinister copse. Oh, that gets me bats, I see, that's cool. I could build a military support, ancient armory. I can't build that yet. It'll give me Karen Reyes, Graveguard, Black Knights. That's cool. That'd be expensive as shit, though. Gibbet. I could build infrastructure. Well, I already have a cemetery, right? So, presumably, it would make the most sense right now to get my economy going. Actually, what do I have for,
Come, impress me.
I do have some fell bats already, that's cool. I should probably, let's have a look here. That gives me growth. What does growth do for me in this game? Does it work differently? My public order is minus 29. Oh, Lord. Growth creates population servers. Okay, just like a tilla. Got it. Okay. It'll make my settlement bigger. Tarnished gold shaft. I like that. Balefire brazier. Well, that doesn't... It's not overly needed right now, I don't think. gallows. Impress those idiots. There's no downsides to gold mines in this game, hey? Right. Well, I like income. Give me income. Skeleton spearman.
Don't think so.
What are you doing? Oh, I see, that's a dwarf in city. So what's my diplomatic situation? Hey there, Schwarzschaffen. Action summary, blah blah blah. Diplomacy!
Relations with foreign powers may be managed through diplomacy, my lord.
Thank you.
Consider your situation carefully before accepting any agreement.
These dickheads, these assholes. Can't trade with them. We're at war, obviously. Can trade. Schemer, rune dweller. Interesting. Constantly plots to break friendships, alright?
Welcome, kin. You must want something. It better not be my head.
Trade agreement? That's rude. Alright. Well, so be it. What about Jafbar? Dwarves
here. As long as I am lord, this thing will receive no hospitality from me.
That's extremely rude, don't you think? Well, dwarf beer is worth 18 dark magic. Let that sink in for a minute. Aversion. They don't like me because I'm an undead. That's rude. Do you want to have a trade agreement, though? No? Okay. Alright. You guys are dicks. Don't like any of you. The Empire. Yeah, whatever. Bunch of bullshit. Nothing really matters right now. Da bloody spears.
I could die for dead things to start yabbering at me. You lot should be in the crowd.
Well, that's rude too. Everyone's racist. None of that's really gonna help me much here. Everyone hates me.
Darkness comes.
It's a tough life being undead, let me tell you. Anyway, we need to get to work here. So let's start by raising the dead. Okay. And going after this piece of garbage. No, so there's two armies here, right?
Such a thing is impossible.
Well, what do they have? Dire wolves, zombies, skeletons, whatever. Nothing that matters over much. They're probably gonna retreat. Oh, no. Here we go.
Battle is upon us. Study your options carefully. The enemy are close. Blood will be spilt.
Quite so. Okay. Winds of Magic Power Reserve. 60. Okay, interesting. Very interesting. Alright. Fuck it, let's get to it. Our first battle. Crypt ghouls are barely sentient, but they can fight using their claws and makeshift weapons to crypt men apart, yes. Well, crypt ghouls in Warhammer are actually alive. Back in the 6th edition Vampire Count's Army book, it mentioned that they were not actually undead, technically, although they are driven by the vampires.
Your soldiers are ready to deploy for battle, my lord.
Gamble.
They await
what the hell
your
is this?
Orders.
Interesting. 13. Power reserves complete. The recharge rate decreases. Let's see. Interesting. Okay. Risk magic for more favorable winds. That's interesting. Well, back in tabletop, you had to roll for the winds of magic. Zombies, good binding. Skeletons. That's interesting how zombies are so spread out. Very interesting. Dire wolves, they're more like skirmishers than anything. Skeletons and the stick at Dieter the Stickler? Sure, go with that.
Address me as master.
Monfred here. What is the thing here? What are these buttons? Toggle guard mode. Hey, guard mode's back! Thank fucking god, I love guard mode. Group, yep. Toggle melee mode, that's all good. See my spells anywhere here. Master of the Black Arts. That's cool. It's a vampiric power on tabletop. Unless you reroll the winds of magic. Improved power recharge rate, improved power reserves. Goose. Alright, well, typically, in tabletop, my plan would be to put a strong center here. Anything I want to hold up particularly, I just put zombies in its way. Because they're quite good at tying things up for a bit and then dying. Alright. Skeletons. Go over here. I'm not sure how this will work. I know in Shogun you wanted like really, in the previous Total Wars, you wanted these really thin formations like this, so they'd run around the flanks. And then in Attila Total War, with the way the fatigue worked, you wanted more deep formations, so you could switch units in and out and have them absorb charges bracing better. Let's see here. Well, we're just gonna put these useless zombies on this flank. And then we're gonna overload this flank, I think.
These lands are mine.
Then we'll have Monfred in the middle to go where he needs to. So we'll try to strike them hard on the left flank with the Vargolf and the Ghouls, which are more offensive units. Bat swarms. Yes, I heard you, go away. Flying war beasts. Expendable. They try their best, let's be honest here. I'm not sure how flying works in this game, so we're about to find out, I suppose. Anyway, I will regroup my units. Maintain formation. I don't think I need to gamble. I kind of have these guys. Yeah. 13. Okay. One power per 6 seconds. Okay.
Unfred von Karstein.
So what spells have I got here? Do I have invocation? No. Do I have this? No. I'm too dumb to use magic yet, apparently. That's fine. Start the battle.
Your flying units afford you great flexibility, Commander. Scout and harass the enemy as they maneuver.
I'll learn more about them later. Right now, I'm gonna go do this.
Pass.
Do you now? I'm not sure that's true. Ooh, zombies, you try. stumble towards the enemy and do something or other. I have lots of HP, that's nice. How much HP does Moan for that?
Hearken to mine will.
Hearken to mine will. I like his old English. I don't really need that right now, do I? Oh no, you do have this spell, don't you? Invocation of the heck. Sweet. Okay.
The winds of magic blow strongly in this place, Commander. Harness its power.
Yes, I understand that. So they're on a hill here, yeah? Okay. Going through a forest. Dire wolves. Very fast. Weak against armor. Okay. Another Total War games, of course, you'd have the... If you're going uphill, you tend to be having a problem, generally. I have to take time to get used to that, set that option, where if you click and drag, you don't automatically run, like it was in Attila. I suppose I could set it back, but I always preferred this method, so I was annoyed by it. Then I got used to it. You know. Anyway, let's speed this shit up. Here we go now. Oh, right. I mentioned that. I love this. Skeletons march in unison.
You can use the maps available to assist your tactical planning.
I don't have a tactical map, dummy. I'm on legendary. Good lord. How do I turn you off? I'll turn you off later. Thanks, bats. You guys are cute. Strong binding. Thanks. I need to change that, actually. That option. Right, I can change... Oh yeah, here we go. I don't need that garbage, particularly. No, I don't need even stat bars. I don't need banners. Fire arcs I like, movement paths I like, character auras I like. I don't need a unit threat level, particularly. That's more like it. It's more immersive, I think, when you don't see any of that garbage. You can just see the units. You go, skeletons. Under the command of one will, Manfreds. Alright, what are you doing, zombies? It is not the formation I ordered you in. You goddamned idiots. Oh well, whatever. Here we go. I've waited a long time for this moment to finally have vampire counts in an actual Total War game. I know there was a mod, but I never played it. Yes. Scarytons. Actually, hold on. You guys get in guard mode. Not you, because you're more aggressive. Not you. Not you, because you're skirmishers. Alright, let's go this way. You're fast, right? Oh yeah, you are fast.
The enemy command the high ground.
Yeah, whatever. High ground's not that high, truth be told. Okay. Alright. Here we go. You halt, you halt, you halt. You charge them. You charge them. You wanna fight these guys? Sure, go for it, buddy. What do I care? Where'd their wolves go? Are they here? Oh yeah, they're here. Actually, let's try a ridiculously ineffective zombie plan, shall we? Okay, you guys. Around here. Alright, you. Where's Dieter gone? I don't see that dickhead. Is he here? Yeah, he is.
The gash was weak. Witness true power. Undeath for all.
Sure, undeath for all. Hurry up, guys. Oh, right, they don't run now. Right, right, right. Those stupid things get killed already? Oh, no. They're crumbling, though. Hit them in the rear. You guys get up here. Attack them. Man, I need to... I'm not gonna get used to this at all. Invocation of Nahek. Stop dying is what I'm trying to say to you. Alright, that thing's going on. They're crumbling. Is this critical binding? Them in the rear. Seems to be going well. Where's this cockpack? Disintegrating? Brutal. It's a tough life, eh?
The enemy general is slain, my lord. Cursing your name with his dying breath. Send his army after him.
Of course, undead don't rot. They just fall down. Well. The laughter of our gods. The only gods the Empire have are themselves. I guess Nagash, sort of, but... You heard Manfred. He's not a big fan of Nagash anymore. Oh. That went reasonably well. I need to get used to that. Or change that thing back, actually. Just because it's not gonna fly with my muscle memory there. Anyway. Awesome.
Victory is yours, my lord. But what about the fate of those captured in battle?
Murder captives.
It can be beneficial to hold them. But sometimes leniency
return captives
can be worth more.
Dominate captives. I think the replenishment's what I want, actually. Yeah. Get back here, you coward.
Those that serve your cause gain experience over time, my lord.
Sweet.
Sure to guide their development to your advantage.
Yes, yes, shut up, would you? Yes. Rank 2. Awesome. I need to set these options, though. Game settings. Default to Roman Dragon units. Yeah, I can't do it. always, thank you. Okay.
Mission is vulnerable to attack, Dark Lord.
Shut up, buddy.
Seize it from the enemy to open a new front to the north.
Do not mistake me for the fool.
Never.
Why don't we just push in and finish them off? Since their army is right there, rather than leaving. Whatever. Shut up, advisor! Student of the Black Arts. That's cool. Dark Acolyte. Count. Oh, +5 versus Hunams. Hunams! Okay. Right. I wanted to go to campaign settings. What was I doing? I like 40 minutes generally. Advice frequency minimal. Go away. You're annoying me. I'll figure it all out myself, damn it. Anyway. Can I raise more dead? Not yet.
No.
He's got
you're
7.
Ruled. Thine right is mine.
Well, let's level you up, guy. How do I skills, here we go. Okay. Or of supremacy. The restless dead. That's nice. Spirit leech. Available after unlocking. Well, is that not good enough? How many points does that take? 1, 2? It takes both? What? Oh, I only have 1 point. Oh, I'm ranked 2, I have 1 skill to spend. That makes sense. I see. Well, Monfort's not really a close combat kind of guy. He's more of a raise the dead kind of guy, right? Available, passive ability, constant, great increased power reserves, power recharge. That's cool. Constant, replenishes HP of combatants, resurrects dead combatants. Interesting. Let's go with this. Invocation of Nahek. And go from there. Alright. We'll need to be aggressive here. Fort Orbersteyr. In the lore, that place was taken over by a bunch of spirits. You are attacking Templehof. What's their garrison look like here? Okay. Interesting. And then they're going to be coming in with reinforcements. I see. This is the... It has to be the garrison army, presumably. Bunch of bats, bunch of spearmen. Interesting. We might be able to beat them, I don't know. Depends. I feel like we need to be aggressive here. What's the terrain look like? Can you tell me? I see. Fuck it. It's the first turn. If I get destroyed, I can always reload, right? That'll be pretty much the end of my campaign. Okay. Wow, that description's really rude to Skeletons. They try so hard. Reinforcing army, Templehof here. Wait, really? I can see that they're gonna reinforce here and like just deploy around them and be like, "Sup, you're dead." Cause that'd be fucking hilarious. Huh. Okay. Well, why not? Does it say where exactly they'll be coming? Interesting. I kind of want to flank them, right? But, interesting.
Attend me!
Well, that's interesting. Never told you any of that before. Very interesting, if you ask me. Maybe some reserves? Interesting. Guard known. Gotcha. Cool. Alright. Let's see what happens, I guess. This is very interesting. Are they just gonna come right here? Oh, I haven't started the battle. There we go. Oh no, they're coming there. I see. Okay, I see how that goes. Interesting. Need location of the hit. Let's hold some reserves here. You head over that way. Head this way. Where's my Vargol? Hit him hard. Put them in there. Kill them. Okay. He's in the ghouls, if you'd be so kind. Them in the rear. That's a lot of shit there. Dear. Did they run? Yeah, they did. Get out of guard mode if you're gonna fight those things, I guess.
Thy serve me. All life must end.
So you've mentioned, actually. Where's their stupid leader? I can't fucking tell. Critical binding. Well, that's unfortunate. You guys back off, maybe?
Power.
He's still fucking around there. Can you go around the flank, maybe? That'd be ideal. It's ideally. And what is going on with these bats? Try to go in the flank here. Hit them in the flank as well. Oh, this is going horribly. Did not anticipate this. Being quite this way. Crumbling damage sustained. Jeez. Things look bad for our heroes right now, don't they? And shouldn't you guys be dead? Piss off. Is everyone engaged here? Stable finding. Oh no.
Empower me, so be it.
Where's their actual general here? See him? No. They probably have, of course, their necromancer casting spells too, right? So it's not all that easy. I could see him, but I don't see him. That's the problem, I suppose. Maybe that'll help. I don't know.
I serve me. I am God.
Well, things are not looking good for our heroes at all here.
I'm the true emperor.
I need to find their fucking general is all, but I'm having a really hard time doing that right now. Oh, and their bullshit's coming from behind too. Seriously though, I can't find him! Oh lord. Bad things are happening to me. So you can go around the back. No, actually go. You don't have enough kills, Vargolf. This is all your fault. Yeah, I think if I had this to fight again, I would obviously not do it quite this way. Still, there's no risk to take, I suppose, knowing that they were obviously more powerful.
Are mine.
Or are they?
Address thee as master.
Interesting. That obviously did not go as planned. That thing kind of got, like, stuck into combat in a way I didn't really want it. I wanted to hit the flank, right? But it ended up getting surrounded. A little bit obnoxious. Yeah. And I couldn't find their general either. There he is now.
Behold, endless night.
Well, that was a fucking disaster. Can you get the hell out of here? Yeah, looks like you can, maybe. Oh yeah, you're fucked, dude. You don't got a fucking prayer. Flee! Ah! The enemy's superior tactics. No, we'll go with that. Looks like we got pretty much annihilated. What did we manage to do? Eh, we hurt them a bit. Interesting. Of course, Legendary Computer will just rebuild all that book instantly. Oh, it'll be bad. Close defeat. Okay. Run away, Manfred. Well, that didn't exactly work. many can I recruit in a turn? I see. Interesting. Of course, they'll probably attack me next turn. Because I've got their replenishment rate, yeah. And this campaign's probably fucked right now, just for managing to lose that battle. But, you know, so be it.